Hello, welcome to this tutorial. My name is Wim Gestel. I come from Holland. And yeah, sometimes I get questions about how I produce my music and how I make my videos and what kind of synthesizer I use and yeah, what are VST instruments and which I use for the vocoder and that kind of questions. So I decided to make a tutorial. Now for the recording, the audio, I use the internal audio card of my PC and I use the N-Track Studio software. It's a very good software. When I record the audio, I have no glitches or anything. And it's very not very expensive on the N-Track Studio site, so you can download it and buy it there. Now I can show you my setup. This is the Korg C1 synthesizer. That's the main synth I use, also as a controller, master keyboard, everything. But also the sounds are fantastic on the synth. I've connected with a MIDI, with a USB MIDI adapter to the PC, so I can the notes I play on the keys can I send to the PC. Now the audio I have connect to the input of the Roland MC808 and the output of the Roland is connected directly to the line input of my motherboard onboard module audio card, and it's nothing. It's just the onboard card, so nothing really special. So I turn on the mix in, and then if I play on the Z1, the sounds will go to the Roland to the PC. So now this is the factory patch B70 Z World, so just a factory patch of the Korg C1. It's also a programmer patch. There's no multi layers on it. And yeah, it sounds like this if you don't just play on it. This synth has also an XY pad. You can change the sound completely. So if I play now, I use the XY pad, and the sound will sound different. Cool sound. So the Roland I have also connected with MIDI to the PC. I set up the system and on USB to MIDI, and I've connected with the USB to the PC, so I can control this also with MIDI. And the sequencer I put in slave mode, and then I that's necessary for the clock timing will come from the software sequencer from my PC, so all the delays and everything will be synchronized. I don't use the sequencer, the internal sequencer of the Roland. I don't use it right now. So now for the VST instruments, I use Cantable Performer as a VST host software, because if you have a VST instrument, it's just a dynamic library for Windows DLL, and yeah, you need a hosting software, and I use Cantable Performer because this software synchronize and receives also the MIDI clock events for my software sequence, and then it synchronize. So if you have beats or samples or anything, you can synchronize it to the clock BPMs. Now I open the software, and then as you can see here, you can configure the MIDI. Oh, I forgot something. Yeah, I can configure it directly to the MIDI of the Korg C1 or anything, but now I use loop MIDI software. It's a loopback MIDI device driver. I open this one. And if I, yeah, you can download it for free on the loop MIDI site. It's from Tobias Echissen. It's a free software, and it's a very good loopback driver. I just use only one port. I use this one because I want to connect the Cantable Performer to my software MIDI sequencer. So leave it there. I open Cantable again, and then I go to the setup, and I go to the MIDI devices, and as you can see, it's already configured because I use it multiple times. Now you see here the loop MIDI port driver. Now I've selected that one. Now it's input, only as input. And the clock must be on yes, because otherwise it will not synchronize all the good stuff. So now, what I can do is add one VST instruments. I use different kind of VST instruments. Nexus is very good. Omnisphere I use. Yeah, a lot of others. Now for the piano sound, I use Ivory VST. Select this one. And this is the Ivory piano. And now there are very good pianos in this Ivory VST. The Bösendorfer has really great sound. I take Bösendorf Big Halton. Yeah, it's loading. Now it's opened. You hear the sounds directly. Now what I do, because I have connected the Cantable software to the loopback MIDI driver, I can play the Korg, but nothing happens there. I turn off the Korg sound. So now I start my software sequencer. It's my own developed software. It's not available online or something. I've developed it on my own in Visual Studio. And the software is built on blocks. It's using the composite object-oriented pattern. And make your music with blocks. Now I start it. I can also run standalone, but I do it now in Visual Studio. Now I start a new project, and there are a lot of different blocks in this program. Grooveblock. In Grooveblock you can put notes, control change blocks, compound block. You can have multiple different blocks in a compound block. You can have two groove blocks or other blocks. Part block. They can have different blocks, and I can use a controller to change the blocks. Sequence blocks, an arpeggiator block, isn't it? A slicer block, switcher block. Switch block, I can use two different patterns, and I can use, for example, the modulation wheel or just a MIDI controller to fade one pattern to the other. So the MIDI notes will, can be shuffled or anything, the velocity, timing, morphing, just like morphing the one pattern to the other. Then there's also a transpose block. So I can, when I have make a groove on this, then I can use the MIDI notes to change the pitch real time. Now then have we also an input MIDI block, and I add that one. And this I can use to redirect the MIDI. Now, if I go to the devices, as you can see, the AMU MIDI cable on this device, I've connected the Core Z1 is the input channel, and the Cantable software I've connected to the loop MIDI port. So Cantable Zoom. And what I do now is, this is device 2. This is the input, I change to device 2, and the output I change to device 6. And I enable redirect notes, so the notes on the input go to the output. I can also redirect control changes. You can also use a range. So I start the block, and then the notes will redirect. So if I play now on the Core C1, you will see the notes it will redirect via my sequencer to the Cantable software. So what I can do is give some short demo from how it sounds together with the Core C1. So if I play now you hear the. Also, the foot controller works with it. So this is my sustain pedal. So if I then of course I need to redirect the control changes also. Otherwise, the sustain pedal will not work. So now press it. Very beautiful sound. You also can change the parameters, key noise, a bit more of key noise. You can also change performer audience, the stereo width. There's also effects on it. I'll leave it like this right now. So you will now hear more key noise. Now I can turn on the audio of the Core C1. So then it will be mixed together. So and it just links together. I can change to other factory pads, Interstate, very cool sound hook. That was fantastic to change the sound. So, let's switch back to the PC. And now what I now can do is add a vocoder, for example. New. And then I select, I use the image line vocodex vocoder. Open this one. And yeah, you can set in different parameters. Now, to enable the sound, as always, I have to search where to click, but you have to click on the microphone. And I have now also connected the microphone to the input of the Cantable software. I use the Cantable software is also configured with Azure for All, as you can see here. And, this is the audio microphone. So close that one. Now to enable the audio input for the vocoder, you have to click on this, the microphone, and then go to the input must be turned on, of course. And as you can see, this is the input of my microphone, and it's reacting, and also the vocoder is reacting, but you don't hear, there's no sound coming from it. So when I start pressing keys, I turn off the audio of the Z1. So press this chord, you can hear the sound very put this on. And I select here, I select the preset, clear for example. And now you will hear my voice also in the vocoder sound. I turn off this notes. The notes must come from the MIDI and not... Yeah, you can also use one note. It's very boring. So, if I press a chord... Then it must be... Turn on my chord. So now is the so when I press notes, then the vocoder starts working. If I don't press a note, no vocoding. What I can do is change the settings of the vocoder, because now it's like it's not really usable. It's more like a robot sound. Now I can change it to super saw. Test. I get all a bit better sound. So what I can do is this is all much better. You can change all the parameters here, so you get a more like old robot sounds. And this is more like a robot, and it's more usable for singing. So now I enabled the vocoder. We have the Korg C1 sounds.
Okay. We have also the sound of the
I'm not really a good singer, but with a vocoder it sounds a bit better than my voice. What I can do is, because I have now the Ivory VST instrument and the vocoder, but yeah, you can add a lot of more VST instruments in this software. And yeah, to change the levels real time of the gains of all the VST instruments, I use the IDJ controller, but you can also use this controller or whatever you like, but I have bought a separate controller device because it's more easy. And what I do is redirect also the notes from the events from this device to the Cantable software. Otherwise, you cannot use it. So I stop this one. I add a new input MIDI block, and this one I configure. I go back to devices. To device 3 is the Icon IDJ device, the input channel, there's two, and I think this was on the channel, but I'm not sure. What I can do is, I need it also redirect. Rider back to device 6 with the Cantable loopback MIDI. And I redirect it to another channel. Channel 3. And redirecting the notes is for the pads. And redirecting the control changes is for the real-time controllers. I will only redirect the control changes now. So I have now two MIDI blocks. So I can start this one. So now it's the for this IDG controller. And then if I turn it, you see here the MIDI is receiving. Nothing happens. It's only events. And so what I do is I click the gain, and I with the right mouse button, and then assign a MIDI controller. Now I turn this knob and assign. Now it's assigned. And I can also do it this one, the vocoder. Assign. Okay, assign. So, if I play now, there's no redirect because it's only one MIDI block. And really now. So, what I'm gonna do is in my software, I add a compound block. And a compound block can have multiple lines. And for this time, I use it. Set it to 2. Now, this is the input MIDI block 0 and 1. So I have now the two blocks together in one block. And what I can do is the default block to play, I can set it up to compound block. And if I start this block, I can start it here or also start it there. Start it now. Then the IG events will redirect to the Cantable software and also the Korg C1. And if I turn the knobs, you will see it changing the gains. And I also can play on the Korg C1. And you will hear also the vocoder, and I can change also now the vocoder sound, so no vocoding and a lot of vocoding. So I can use this to mix real time all the different VST instruments, because I can add a lot of more VST instruments right now. I can show another one. So I put add a new rack, new plugin, and I select Nexus, for example. Knob 3 assign. So I can also change the levels, audio levels. And if I play now, you will hear, select arpeggiator. Nexus VST. Sounds in it. There are also sequences in it. Everything. I have the SID expansion. I think that it sounds. What I can do this. This moment maybe not the best choice, but now I can play and add also the vocoding and the piano and the Korg C1, so all together. This is the Delta sequence from the Delta Commodore 64 game, but. Just a simple sample. There are also a lot of pads in it. Try the different sounds. It's just like mixing. So I can mix the audio together with the Z1, and then you can get very cool combinations. I have a Nexus pads and a Korg C1 together, and the audio levels can change real time. Yeah, maybe we have to take a sequence. This is okay. What we can do, I can give some demo about how to play this. It's on, now, mostly of my songs are just improvising. It's not really, it's not really, really very complex. It's more, I play more the simple, easy things. So, it's just improvising. What I can do now is I press my sustain switch. The sound will keep on playing, and now I have free to change the controls. You get the ID. This is how I do this part. But I can show some more of my sequencer software. And I stop the block. So that's this configuration. And as I can do now, I can add, for example, a groove box, and I will show you how to make a simple groove. Because it takes more time to make a complex groove. But these are just MIDI notes. In it, you can select different notes. You can change the step duration. You can add more steps if you like. This is every block has a step duration and steps. So what I do is I change it to 8, then it's more the double of the length, and then I change it to 12, so because then it's the duration is divided by 2, and then if you multiply it, you will also have the same as the other blocks. And the MIDI channel on the MIDI device, I change it to the Roland device, so check it. MIDI output channel, the MC808 Roland is device 5. Now, go to the groove block, device 5. And if I play now, then it will. You get this sound. Now, what I can do is select all the notes, change it to a bit lower. I can change the sound also. I can maybe some different guitar units. That's really nice, but yeah, if you want to use it in a song, then you have to transpose the sounds, because otherwise you will play all night long on the same chord. Of course, you can make different notes and different patterns, and all the blocks you can put together, you can put more blocks in a compound block, and you also can put a compound block in another compound block. It's very flexible. But now what I'm gonna do is add one transpose block, and for the transpose block I need to use an input detection. I can use input MIDI block 0 from the Core C1, but then all the notes will be used for the redirect. It's not very very handy. So what I do is I copy this block, clone, get a copy of the input block, and I enable the range, and yeah, this is all okay. This is the lower part of the and it's copied, so it's also the Core C1. And I don't use the redirect in this block, because there's no need to redirect this. And then I go back to the transpose block, and I select that copied block, and that's only the lower part input of the Core C1. I can also change the names, but this takes too much time. To transpose, I need to transpose block. Now, of course, I select just the groove block, but you have only one groove block. And in practice, you will you can transpose also a compound block, or you can transpose a transpose block if you like, but a switcher block, a slicer block. You have also a arpeggiator block, and you can transpose the arpeggiator block, or you can use the input for the arpeggiator, and you can use the transpose block. You can very flexible. So let's keep it easy, and I select groove block 3, and now I can change also some settings from the initial note, the bass note, and also the transpose mode. There are all different transpose modes in it, but check this one, single note retrigger on transpose change. And if I play this block, you will only hear the MC808, because we have made that groove, and we can transpose it. So let's do that. If I press note here, you can hear the transpose. So that's very simple. What I can do now is add some drums. And I copy the groove block. Clone. I will rename this onto drums. And of course, yeah, drums don't need to be transposed, otherwise you get a lot of different drum sounds. I take part 10, and now open this block, set it to MIDI channel 10. Look at it. Like this. Very simple drum pattern. So if I play this one, you should hear drums. Turn on the drums. So very simple. Can maybe make it like this. So we have the drum, and what I can do now is put it in the compound block. So I open again the compound block, and for example the drums. Now we have now the drums and the Korg C1 with the VST instruments. So if you listen now, you will hear the rhythm of the VST, the rhythm of the Nexus will also be synchronized with the drums. So that's the really cool part of taking all the sequences. So you hear the synchronization, and if I change the speed, that's really cool, really cool. I can also make it very slow. It's really slow. So now what I do, I add also the groove block 0 with the one pattern I made, and I have to of course I need a transpose block, otherwise I cannot transpose. So now I have two input blocks: the groove block, the drums, the transpose blocks, which transpose the groove sound of the Roland. And if I start now, then we hear all it together. So I can change the instruments here if I like. If Now I can start mixing all together. Sample, but I can also make configurations with the switcher block. It's like morphing patterns together, and I set here sounds, there sounds, change it all real time, and morphing the rhythms of the MC accelerator to the different patterns. I can change the sounds now, so maybe get some other ideas. So the transposing is important, and the synchronization is of course very important. So I stop now the sequencer, and this was the tutorial, and of course I can show a lot more, but then it will take too long time. So I hope that this just give you the idea how I produce my music, and I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching this video.